Thank you for joining us. This video is brought to you by thestreamingadvisor.com, and it is an extensive look at the Nvidia Shield TV Pro. This is the new 4K HDR Android TV box from Nvidia. And we're going to start with just looking at the basics of what comes in the box. You see the new remote control with all of the volume and TV controls. You have the new Nvidia Shield device itself with the more powerful processor. They say that it's 25% faster than the last generation, much less the old Nvidia Shield Pro, which you see in the background on the desk. This has all of the basics you need: Ethernet, two USB 3s, and power, of course. Now, but look at it compared to the older model. It is so much smaller. It's to a point where it almost looks like what you would think of as the mini version, like when you see the NES Mini or Sega Genesis Mini. But it's designed to take up less room. One thing you do lose, though, besides the 500 gigabyte hard drive, is there is no SD card slot in the newer model. If that is a holdup to you, you know, then that's going to be a problem. There's also one less USB slot. So, along with the actual device itself, like you said, we have the remote control. And this is a backlit remote, and it's designed to, you know, sit up, stand. It's just a real departure from what they had before. It even has the dedicated Netflix button. But you see that you can just kind of stand it up on a desk or on a table. So it's a lot easier to keep up with. And on top of that, Nvidia even includes a way to page the remote if you lose it, which is, you know, something that you might have gotten comfortable with other things. Inside the box, you'll also find the power plug, which comes pre-assembled, unlike the old one. It still comes apart if you want it to. As well, you have two very brief guides. One of them is as simple as saying, you know, hook it up to your HDMI and plug it into the TV and plug in the power. Other than that, there is actually nothing else to see here. If you manage to pull the bottom of it out, and you'll see it's kind of secure, you will find there's nothing else in there. And that's important because that means it does not come with a gamepad. If you remember, the original Nvidia Shield devices came with gamepads, and then they transitioned over time to include a separate remote. And after they had the separate remote, they even included, you know, finally, you know, started shipping it with its remote. The new device will fit in the stand for the old device, so if you're doing an upgrade, you don't necessarily need to order a new stand. It doesn't fit perfectly. If you want one that fits perfectly, they do make a newer stand that's designed for the, you know, miniaturized version of this device. But that's what is included with. So what we're doing here is we've got it hooked up to the TV, and you'll notice it's telling you to press the little round button at the top of the remote. So we're going to do that, and you're going to get an idea of what it means to have a backlit controller here. I think the Netflix thing looks really pretty, doesn't it? But, you know, here you can see all of the buttons, including the microphone button and so on. And really all you got to do is sort of nudge the controller, tap on it. You can even slide across the button. Sometimes we'll activate it. But we're going to press that round button as we're instructed so that we can get the process started to get this all set up and going in its 4K streaming glory, all right? So, we speak United States English, so we're going to choose that, although there are tons and tons of other language options, including other English dialects. So, you know, if you happen to live somewhere else and want to use your native version of English, feel free. But we're going to go ahead and hit United States English and kind of move on from there. Now, Nvidia, like other Android TV devices, allows you to set things up with your phone or using the remote. We're going to show you what it looks like to set things up with the remote briefly. You choose your network. You have to type in your network password, and we're going to skip that step and just fast forward to the next. And from there, you connect to your network. If you choose to go through the phone itself will figure out what you're trying to do and get you all set up with that part of the process. Play the waiting game for a minute, and again, it asks you to sign in. This again will give you the option to use your phone or the remote. And I highly recommend using your phone or a computer, because that way you don't have to poke around on the little, you know, the on-screen keyboard. So let's take a look at what happens if you say use your phone or computer. And what it does is it gives you an address to go to where you can find what you need, and it provides this little 6-digit code. So you go to androidtv.com/setup, type in the code, and it will begin to set you up. It even gives you a chance to choose which Google profile you want to use. So if you've got a couple, that's all you have to do. So if you choose to use your remote, again, you have to type in your email address, whatever your Google email address is. You got to remember your Google password. And, you know, that's where I just feel like it's easier to not have to worry about it. Otherwise, they do give you all the tools that you need, including at the top. You know, you don't have to type in your entire email address. And if you need various symbols, they're there too. But we skipped that step for the purposes of this video, and we're signed in. We go on ahead and accept everything. And here you can choose to help Android or not. I'm going to be nice and say yes. We'll get the Google Assistant going, because that makes things easier as far as using the device. And if you have Google devices, you know, whether it's a home or lights, you know, you can use things like that to communicate with your stuff. So we're going to turn on personal results, because that's helpful. That makes it easier to discover content. It's going to give you ideas like, oh, maybe you would like to watch this. And the final step in this is it just gives you an idea of what it is to own an Android TV device. If you've never used one before, this is just a little roundabout way of saying, you know, this is our stuff. So, once you get to that point, you've got to start going through all the fun legal stuff. And Nvidia puts it out there so that you can really take a look at it. You can read the entire license agreement. You can read the, you know, terms of use. And, you know, I gotta say, at least it's pretty straightforward. Even it tells you what you can get out of your privacy policy. See, they, you know, it shows you what they're going to look at, how they're going to use it, and that's good. That's transparent compared to some companies. So we're just going to flip through that just to let you see what that looks like and move on. So we're going to agree. Hopefully there's nothing dastardly in there. This is a chance to join their program, and we're not going to do that. That's a paid thing. And this is something new. This is a chance to add apps that you already have via your Google sign-in. So because we used the sign-in that we've used the last time we set up an Nvidia Shield, it recognized that we had certain things downloaded through the Google Play Store. And this allows you to just put them in place without having to go on and re-add them when you get everything started. So we're going to go ahead and click Add. And it's letting us know that there is an upgrade available for the what they call the Nvidia Shield experience. That's really just firmware. But it's letting us know what we can do with it and tells us we've got to restart to install that, and we're going to do so. So you get this little guide here, and it takes you through a restart. Just don't do anything. Don't unplug the device once it restarts. Once it turns off, it's just going to automatically do it. And when it does, this is what you'll see. It upgrades the experience. I don't necessarily think the little green line means that anything's being upgraded, but you know, it's just a matter of showing you what you're, you know, just to give you a feel that something's happening. This can take a bit, so we're going to reduce this clip just a little bit so that we can move on. Otherwise, we could sit here all day. Setup for this actually took somewhere around an hour because of all of the different things it had to update. You know, but we're just trying to give you a feel what you're going to see. So it has finished updating, and we're launching into the actual Android TV operating system. It also notices that it's got to do an upgrade on some accessory things. And so we're going to finish that, and it's going to recognize, this way it'll recognize when things need to be updated and give you an alert. So here you're going to see what Android TV looks like. If you have not seen this before, this is a standard system. It has the look of lots of things, TVs, other Android things. And you see we have a little alert that says there's a Shield accessories update. So we're going to take a look at that and see what we need to update. It's helpful just to go ahead and make sure everything's up to date before you start using the device. If you click on details here, it'll show you what it is. So we're going to continue this and let it do that update. Once this update is done, the Shield should pretty much be ready to go as far as all of the hardware. Though there is probably going to be some sort of software update because it's fresh out of the box. So, it says it's updating and we have successfully updated the Shield remote. And here we are. So now, it has been upgraded, and we can dismiss that announcement. And boop, there we go. Okay, so, here we are, and this is the home screen for the Nvidia Shield. Up here are items that had been saved as favorites. So it gives you a little row. You can have as many or as few things as you want in the favorites menu up here. Otherwise, all of your apps are down here, if you need to click on the red apps button. And this is everything that we went ahead and imported over. You'll see the little lines at the bottom of these apps mean that they are upgrading the apps or updating them. If you're familiar with anything to do with apps, whether it's through a phone or through a streaming device, you know, you'll know that there's always updates coming. So this is just doing it automatically for us. But the home screen on this is pretty unique. It takes the apps that you have and makes little suggestions for you as far as content you might find interesting. You can customize what is on that group of rows. And you'll see as more things are updated and ready to go, the amount of types of things that you can customize here does change. Right now it's pretty basic, but there's a lot of stuff out there, and the idea behind Android TV's setup is that a million things to watch is great, but if you don't know what the heck is out there, it doesn't do you a whole lot of good. So what we're going to do here is take a look at some things. We're going to go into settings and see what makes this thing really churn. The settings menu has changed a bit from 9.0 from where it used to be. You see that you can get into everything as far as its video upscaling, which is important. This means that you can tell something to maybe, if that isn't in 4K, to look better. You can access your networks if you didn't set them up correctly before, or if you, you know, let's say you set up a new modem or something like that. You'll notice there's an Ethernet option, and if you can plug this into the Ethernet, that's great. You can add a more private network if you need to, and now and then you need to restart Wi-Fi, so it's good to know where that is. Otherwise, the Wi-Fi settings are pretty clear, but this is where you're going to find them if and when you need them. Otherwise, this is where you would find what was traditionally the standard menu under device preferences. About is where you're going to go to see your upgrade. You can restart, you know, without unplugging, things like that. The display and sound is great. It shows you everything you need to know about setting this up to optimize the video for your TV. AI upscaling is, like I said, it helps you figure out how to make things look at their best. When you start messing with these settings, you could very well throw something off, so be careful unless you're, you know, really comfortable and familiar with these sorts of things. For the purposes of this video, I think we're just going to kind of leave it alone. Now, this is an important thing. If you're using your Shield and you're like, why can't I see? You know, why is it smaller than the screen? Adjust for overscan is where you're going to go to change the size of your screen. That's very important, so you don't have a little screen within a screen. CEC is great because what that allows you to do is control the Shield with other controllers if your TV controller works with it. I find that my Hisense TV works very well with Android TV devices. This just allows you to control how much louder your voice is going to get if you tell it to turn up volume. Under system, you can find out the basics of things. You see that you can adjust how loud the fan is, things like that. That could make a big difference to you depending on where you're using this. Storage is cool because you need to know how to set things up as far as Plex, which has a server on Nvidia. And it also allows you to see where you're going, you know, how you know, transfer files over to local network. This is important if you're setting up things like hard drives and stuff like that with this system. Under the home screen, you can control all of those little rows that I was showing you. So that's helpful. You can see the keyboard settings as far as what you're using. And if you have a Bluetooth keyboard or a USB keyboard, you can go into the settings here to figure out what you're dealing with. Most people are going to use this with either a video game controller or the standard controller, but there are games that work much better with keyboards. So it's out there, and you see here, there's the virtual keyboard setup. This allows you to see everything you need to do. Date and time automatically sets up if you put it in with location, but you can change over from, you know, the 12-hour to the 24-hour clock. And again, if you're setting this up for somebody else who happens to live somewhere else, you can go in, set up all the settings, and then ship it off to wherever you want and change the language. The Google Assistant is what we were talking about earlier. That's the full-on Google Assistant that controls smart home devices and cameras and anything else. You just press the microphone button to access it. You might not want to use screensavers, but you've got all of the options here to either shut your system down or see pretty pictures, whatever, you know, Google throws at you. Chromecast built in, of course, means that if you have a phone and you want to send video, YouTube, any other Chromecast-enabled app, which there are thousands, all you have to do is tap the little Chromecast symbol and it will send it directly over. Now, this is important. A lot of people, you know, have vision problems, and Nvidia puts a lot in place to help them find the kinds of captions and caption settings that they need. Nvidia also has a sort of a talkback sort of feature, which is good. I don't know how effective it is because, fortunately, I am not visually impaired. But if you go into the accessibility shortcuts, you can see that you can enable it. And I'm actually going to turn that off because you see the little note. It shows if you press the buttons this long, that long, it'll turn it on. And I don't want to accidentally turn it on. So for my case, I'm going to turn it off. But it is there if you need it. And that is very good for those who do. Now, we're going to take a look at Plex on the Nvidia Shield, which is pretty unique compared to other desktop or TV-based sorts of streaming devices. Plex on the Nvidia Shield is different because it has a built-in computer-type server. This is different than everything else because otherwise you need a separate kind of setup, like a separate computer running in order to use it fully. When you click sign in, it gives you a code here. This code is to be utilized on either a mobile device or even just a computer. And we're going to have to go to that address, https://plex.tv/link. Really? You can just say plex.tv/link. You don't need all of that other information. And what we're going to do is show you what happens on that, because we're going to switch over a quick view of our computer and set that up for you. So on our computer, we're going to go to that address, and you see it says a link account. And here is where we're going to type in the code that Plex provided us via the Nvidia Shield. We're going to click link, and you'll see on the TV screen that it's going to change over to start setting up the Plex server. Ta-da! And see, it has a little check mark to enable that Plex server. We're going to go ahead and let that happen, and we're going to go to next and start moving forward. Now, Plex involves accessing media, and so it's going to set up any kind of stored media that you've got on your device. Right now, we really don't have anything on the device because we're just getting it started. But you're just going to want to click on through next and let this do its job. It's going to tells you that it takes a few minutes, and you know it's not lying, but we don't make you wait through the entire process of setting this up. So we're going to let this do its magic and move forward. Okay, so it's all finished, and we're just going to click Finish. And what it's going to do is take us into a new screen where we're going to start getting into the weeds a bit. This is where you choose your server. We have the Shield here, and there are a couple of people who have shared their servers with me, as well as my laptop. And it has a lot to offer. We're going to try to make this a little more simple if you haven't seen it before. I'm going to take out the TV shows section and the movies section and click continue. And you see all of those sections that were displayed before are now little options on the left side. If you have photos saved to your Nvidia Shield, you'll find them there. But Plex has a lot to offer as far as things besides your own media. This has been a steady evolution that involves everything from podcasts to localized, you know, newscasts and so on. There's a lot to offer there. These are radio stations brought in through various third parties. Home videos, we don't have any home videos. And playlists allows you to organize things depending on what you want to watch. What you see right here is mostly podcasts because Plex has a podcast player that is built in. You can set this up to show what you want where. That's helpful. The headline news is really cool because you can basically put together your own news broadcast or your own news streamcast. And you can move where things are. So if you don't want playlists at the top, you can delete it. The settings are rather extensive. You can control everything pretty much from start to finish. What you're going to see, where you're going to see it. And this is where you would access your important server settings. It really is nice to have a server built into the Nvidia Shield. It's unlike anything else out there besides playing out using a PC or something like that. It's like a hybrid between set-top box and HTPCs. So Plex can do a lot, and we've got other videos on Plex that we can link to give you an idea of what you're seeing. But in general, I really like the app. It's great for pulling in digital files. I like it as a podcast player. I like it as a news player, things like that. And it's fun to share things with friends. People with large video libraries can share with you. If you're already familiar with Plex, you already know these things. And if you're not familiar with Plex, please check out some of our other videos on the subject. But that is the Nvidia Shield version of the Plex server, and we'll move on from there. So, right here you're seeing our apps. They're still updating, but we're going to go on and take a closer look at these rows. Like I said before, these rows are, and as I mentioned before, as new things get added in and updated, you have more channels to customize. See, now you've got a Plex channel. We can add the newscast to that, and now anything that comes through the Plex newscast will be available directly from the home page. You see the Nvidia Games channel thing now. We can put that on there and find new games. So, you know, that's just a showing you, you know, the more you have on there, the more rows you'll have. You can turn them on and off, but as it is, I find them helpful. So we're going to jump into like a YouTube row just to show you how this works. This is recommended videos from things that I've watched in the past. So, you know, whatever rando things you like online, that's what's going to show up in recommended. You might be familiar with that already based on, you know, your own YouTube experience. But it's cool that it just puts things right out there for you. I like relaxing music, so I'm going to give this an excellent. Okay. So, oh, look, it tells you thank you. Isn't that nice? It's really just taking your information, but I guess I don't mind when it comes to relaxing videos. But YouTube, you know, the YouTube setup is a great TV-based setup. If you aren't familiar with using YouTube on TV, it's a whole new experience. You almost forget you're watching an app in general. The Nvidia Games, this is a big deal. Now, like I said before, this does not come with a gamepad, but it doesn't mean that Nvidia hasn't kept with their roots as far as games. What they do with games is extensive, especially compared to other things. Even though it's not fully updated yet, we're going to go ahead and open the Nvidia Games app and really take a look at the kinds of things that you can find on here. You'll see that there are some things listed as free for members. That's if you're part of that Nvidia club that we opted out of. But you also see Steam, which means that if you're a member of Steam, which is a computer-based sort of all you want, you know, all you can play service, you can access that from Plex, not from Plex, but from this Nvidia Shield. You don't need to have a Steam machine or run it through a PC. You see, there's free-to-play things. You know, Fortnite's right there. You know, that's, you know, super popular. So that's good for those who love some Fortnite. They can play that on their Shield. It breaks things down into lots of categories, including things you can play with just a basic remote. So this is stuff that you don't even need a, you know, a fancy gamepad for. The cool thing is that depending on what you click on, if you notice, it shows you, you know, gamepad required right there at the top. This way you don't purchase a game that you can't play. But there are numerous categories here, and a lot of the top titles in each category. So that's very helpful in general. But look at all of the different categories, and this is just the Nvidia games section. If you are more of a visual learner, this section here will show you what sorts of things are available as far as genre. There are so many role-playing games. And what you see here isn't necessarily everything that is and everything that will be. Under type, what you see is sort of the range. GeForce Now, GeForce included. Under Android free, these are just, like it says, they're free games that you can download. You can play them. You know, obviously, why else would you download them if you weren't going to play them? They just take up space otherwise. But this is nice. This is good, you know, especially with kids. The free games are a great time killer. And some of them are pretty extensive. I just continually impressed with the amount of titles that are available through any of these sorts of things. The Batman games have always been popular, and in general, you just don't find this with a lot of things. You know, Apple has their new arcade, Roku has very minimal games, Fire TV has Android games, but Nvidia is really the only top-line media player that also includes lots of games. Otherwise, you've got to get something along the lines of a PlayStation 4, Xbox One, something like that. You can get to your full settings through this menu. And if you're looking to try to connect with a computer, you can do so from here too. That's another thing that Nvidia is really well known for, is playing, you know, if you have the correct hardware, you can play a computer game directly on your TV through the Nvidia Shield. So that is the Nvidia Shield's game section, the Nvidia game section in general. There is really a lot to do, a lot to see. And if you're a gamer, you should really enjoy that. On top of that, you can also play Minecraft. I looked that up because my daughter is a big Minecraft fan. You can download the Java version. That means that it's not the mobile version. And the Java version is, you know, the sort of thing you would be more familiar with if you were using a PC. So if you want it, you can get it. You do take note. You will need a keyboard and mouse to do that. But as we've been diving into all of these Nvidia Shield features, we've never really addressed what kinds of apps can you get on this besides what you've seen so far. And there's a lot. The Android Play Store, or the Google Play Store, is designed for your TV. So this is a different sort of Google Play Store than you might be comfortable with on your phone. But you see that it breaks things down into different kinds of categories so that you can find the kinds of things that you want. You notice something that said media, that's just where you would find your basic things like Netflix, stuff like that. While what you think of as the media is located under news. It breaks down games. This is kind of like the free games section that we saw in the Nvidia games section. and has lots of categories again, so that you can find the kind of thing that you might want to play or you might want your kids to play. There's lots of stuff out there. But in the home section here, it breaks things down into categories that you can kind of grasp. I don't know why they have one called Start Streaming, because, I mean, everything is streaming for the most part. But, you know, under Movie Night Starts Here, for instance, you know, you're going to see that there are the standard, most popular movie apps that you think of when you think of streaming, Netflix, Hulu, and so on. It even has a section for free TV and movies, which is cool. But in general, that's what you're going to see in that grouping. This just has a lot to offer. Now, while we've been doing all of this other exploring, Nvidia has been updating the Live TV app. Live TV allows you to do a lot of things, from accessing live television with an applicable tuner, as well as integrating things like Pluto TV and other video services. We have a HD home run already set up. So we're going to type in a zip code. Well, our zip code. That's right, if you're not familiar with 27591, that's Windale, baby. Alright, so, done. And you see that it gives you a chance to select antenna or cable, depending on how you have your tuner set up. Ours is hooked up to an antenna, so we're going to click antenna. It finds the channel lineups. And we're going to just skip this step for a minute, because we don't need to see, you know, everything that it's doing. So we're done. And take a look. It's going to give you a little breakdown of what they are. Der, live channels. It's pretty self-explanatory. And this is live over-the-air TV. We don't need to rerun the channel setup. If you press the center button, you pull up a program guide, and you'll see that the channels are listed. What, you know, what the number is, what network it is, the information. You know, sometimes you'll find it there, sometimes you won't, but it all depends on how strong your signal is as far as whether it loads. But that's it. I think that's a pretty full understanding of the Nvidia Shield Pro. I hope you found that helpful. And if you did, please subscribe. Please share this video with your friends. As always, I'm Ryan Downey, the Streaming Advisor. Stream on, my friends.